Donald Trump was right. Donald Trump was right about NATO, the North Atlantic Treaty Organization. This organization was formed to protect European countries in the West, Western European countries, from Soviet expansion. The United States provided a great deal of military power and resources to back them up and setting up a strong defense against the Soviet Union. Well, the Soviet Union fell, and NATO's been continuing and has been expanding eastward towards Russia, the Russian Federation. And even though they promised not to, they've been doing that. And for the longest, a lot of these European countries, the small ones, have not been paying their fair share as far as the treaty. Now, the whole idea is that everybody dedicates a certain amount of money, certain amount of their gross domestic product towards defense, a certain portion of their economy. And that's defense and security is one of the core responsibilities of a government. Matter of fact, that's the first and foremost responsibility of the government, to defend its people, to provide security. Now, in democratic societies, one of the responsibilities is to protect the rights of its people. But if they don't dedicate any real money to protecting its own border, its own security, then what's the point of the government? Well, a lot of these European governments have been investing, putting a lot of money, and you can say investing, putting a lot of money into welfare and social safety net programs. And because they rely so much on the United States putting military bases in place, providing security, spending a tremendous amount of money on military power, and putting their American military power assets in the region, in those countries, a lot of these European countries have decided that, hey, well, we don't really need to spend that much money on defense because we have Daddy Uncle Sam here to help us out, right? Well, Trump was asked Trump recently came out and said that he was asked by one of those European countries that if they didn't pay a certain amount of money, they didn't pay a certain amount of money to booster up their own defense, and they were attacked by the Russians, will the U.S. still come to help them, right? Because they haven't been doing that. And Trump called him out when he was president. So they say, hey, if we're not spending 2% of our GDP on defense, like we all agreed on, and we get attacked by the Russians, you're still going to come and help us, right? Donald Trump's answer was no. And the media is trying to spin this as some big controversy. I'm thinking, well, if he said yes to that question, there would be no incentive for those countries to actually dedicate serious money to defense. And now they're in a situation where they're scared because Russia is kicking their ass or kicking butt in Ukraine. They're saying, oh, we got to prepare for war, or they're scrambling now. They spent a lot of gear, a lot of their resources on Ukraine, sending stuff to Ukraine, sending money to Ukraine. And now they're talking about, we got to be better prepared to fight Russia. Well, it's like Donald Trump was telling you guys, you got to spend more money on your defense than what you're doing. Donald Trump, this is what I like about this guy. Okay, he reminded me some of the things I enjoy about him in 2016. This week, he also reminded me some things that I didn't like about him. For example, he was commenting on Nikki Haley's husband, who apparently may be out on a military deployment, which is stupid. Why the hell is he still talking about a candidate who's struggling to get 25% in polls? Now, that's just stupid. Where's the discipline there? That's what I don't like about this guy. The drama, the Twitter crap. Okay, I just want somebody to just laser focus on helping the American people. Cut this crap out. Okay, he doesn't need to go to that petty stuff. If he can be disciplined, he can win this race, but I don't really think he can really do. He has a better organization than he did in 2020. I'll put it that way. But anyway, the thing I like about this guy is that he's actually pushing policies that benefit the American people. He's literally putting the American people first. You know, he's not just saying that. He's approaching it from that angle. Like, okay, how does this benefit the American people? It wouldn't benefit the American people to dump a whole bunch of money into some European countries that don't want to spend money on their own defense. You know, if you tell them, I mean, that puts a burden on us. So we got to defend a country that won't invest in their own defense. So, I mean, it just makes perfect sense to me. This is one of the things I like about this guy. So I think he needs to look at the 2016 campaign as far as his messaging. And he needs to focus on, he needs the Barack Obama style organization. It doesn't have to be exactly the same, obviously, but I think they're already doing that. I think his organizations are actually really good this time. They've seen learn the lessons from 2020, And I think they embrace early voting, and I'm cool with early voting. Mail-in voting, I don't like. I think it's just the potential for fraud is just too great. But I really support early voting. People showing up, I like the idea of people being able to show up in person to vote a week in advance. That's great. Show up Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, whenever. That's great. That way you can avoid those long, long lines on election day. That's something that I actually like, but the Republican Party are adapting to this new post-COVID environment. We'll see what happens there. All right, Taylor Swift. At some point, Trump mentioned that he signed the Music Modernization Act because there's all this talk about, oh, Taylor Swift may be endorsing Biden because she definitely supported him in 2020. And he said that she shouldn't endorse Biden because he signed a Music Modernization Act, and it made a lot of money for her. And I just think it's smarter if he just avoids even getting into those type of discussions. I don't think he can win talking about Taylor Swift and in any type of like who is he talking to in this sense? Who is he trying to appeal to? You know, it doesn't make any sense. But, you know, if he can avoid that those type of distractions and focus on what really affects American people the most, then this guy could be the 47th president of the United States. And, you know, is it really going to change the direction of the empire or direction of this country? You guys are going to be the ones to decide that. You guys tell me what you think in the comment section. So anyway, these are my thoughts. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.